Hello, dear students. How are you? I hope all of you are doing well. All of us know that general knowledge or general awareness is very important for all of us. It keeps us updated about our environment and surroundings and also helps us to know about the world better. It involves a wide range of subjects. To start with, we have travel geographically as our first chapter of the class. Everybody likes to travel, but do people actually know the names of the landforms they are moving around? Let's have a look at some of the landforms. Canal, a man-made waterway connection used for transportation and navigation. They may be used for irrigation. Canyon, a deep river valley found in dry region. It is basically found in dry region where the water is scarce. Lagoon, a shallow water body separated from larger water bodies by reef. You can see the water body is separated. Estuary, a wide area of water where river flows into the sea. See, whenever we hear about the flowing of river, we usually hear that the river flows into the ocean. But when it is flowing in a sea, it's called estuary. Next, we have fjord, a deep inlet of the sea formed due to glacial erosion. When the glaciers erode, then this fjord is formed. Next, this all of us know, island. A mass of land surrounded by water. A piece of land that is surrounded by water from all the sides is called an island. For example, we have Lakshadweep Island, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. These are some of the examples of islands. Now let's move to our next chapter, that is majestic birds. These are the birds of prey. They are predators. They kill other animals and eat them. They live on other animals. To start with, we have osprey. It is a fish-eating raptor found on all continents except Antarctica. Next, vulture. This is an exceptionally large bird. It has bald, featherless head and scavenges on dead animals. It basically eats dead animals and it helps in cleaning the environment. Peregrine falcon. It is the world's fastest bird. It has pointed wings built for speed. You can see this beautiful bird and its feathers are pointed. Next, we have owl. It is a bird that hunts at night. We have heard about owl that it does not sleep at night. It has binocular vision and very sharp hearing power. Next, we have bald eagle. It is the national bird of USA. It is a good swimmer and has fish as the main diet. What is the main diet of this bird? It's fish. Harpy eagle, it is one of the world's largest eagles. There are many types of eagles and it is one of the largest eagles. It has a bird's body, fearsome claws and women's face. You can see the combination that the body is of bird. The claws are fearsome, means they are quite pointed and sharp. And its face looks like a women's face. Okay, next, this is women environmentalist. Who is an environmentalist? An environmentalist is a person who is concerned with and or advocates for the protection of the environment. Environmentalist protects the environment and encourages others also to protect it. So we have here some of the great environmentalists of the world. At number one, we have Vandana Shiva. She is an Indian environmentalist. She founded a research institute, Navdanya, in 1991, which aims to promote fair trade practices and protect the diversity of native seeds. She works for the seed recipe. Next, we have Bangari Mathai. She founded the Green Belt Movement, which focused on environmental conservation and women's rights. She was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 2004. Next, we have this lady named Sylvia Earle. She is a part of the Ocean Elders, which aims to protect the ocean and its wildlife. Basically, she works for the cleanliness of the oceans and the wildlife found in oceans. At number four, we have Jane Goodall. She worked extensively on conservation and animal welfare issues. In 2000, she was named UN Messenger of Peace. She has been named as United Nations Messenger of Peace because she works for the conservation and animal welfare issues. Next, we have Isato Sise. He started a recycling movement called One Plastic Bag, which aims to educate people about recycling and reducing the amount of waste produced. She is also known as the Queen of Recycling. She basically worked on recycling, that we should recycle things and we should not waste things. Okay, next chapter is quite interesting one. It is life-saving gadgets. We all are surrounded by a lot of gadgets. Like you are watching this video. It is also with the use of a gadget. You must be watching it in your mobile phone, your laptop or computer. What are these things? All these are devices. So a gadget is a small tool such as a machine that has a particular function, but is often thought of as a novelty. See, in the picture, you can see we have a mobile, we have a remote, we have laptop. So these are all the devices that helps us. They make our life actually easier. Home security system. Yes, we have, at some places we have installed CCTV cameras. It is for security. So a network of devices that work together to secure your home, that is home security system. Next, a device which removes contaminants from the air in a room to improve indoor air quality. Basically, we cannot do really much about the outdoor on single-handedly, but indoor we can purify the air using this air purifier, and nowadays it is quite essential because the environment is not very clean. Next, we have this device that allows you to remotely control your home's temperature via a mobile. It tells us the temperature of the room in which we are sitting. This is smart thermostat. Yes, this all of us know, it is a fitness band, the device worn on the wrist that tracks your heart rate, pulse, steps taken, calories burned, etc. It is a dream of, I think, every child to have this band on their wrist. Next, we have the smartwatch. Yes, this is the latest, the one we actually want, computerized wristwatch that allows you to text or make a call. It is a kind of wrist mobile phone that through which you can make a call or you can even send text messages. Next, we have the smart light. Yes, this is a good invention, I would say. Saves energy by adjusting the light in a room based on size, occupancy, and daylight availability. It basically saves light and it also looks very beautiful. So it is smart light. Next, yes, we must have seen or heard about these. These are smart speaker, like we have Alexa. These are that only. a virtual assistant that offers interactive actions and hands-free activation with voice command. You can give a command via voice. Next, we have this medication dispensing service. Yes, this is quite a good invention. It provides reminders and instructions to the patients about the time of their medicine and helps them to take the right dose. It is actually a good invention because it helps the patient to take the right dose at the right time. Next, we have this pet tracking collar. It is a collar that allows you to track your pet's location in real time. Sometimes we lose our pet because they run away or whatever may be the reason. But this tracker helps us to track the pet and get it back. Then, yes, this is our last one, vacuum cleaner. Vacuums all areas of the room of any shape or size. This is a vacuum cleaner. It helps in cleaning. Okay, so that's it for the class. I hope you would go through this video very carefully and you would learn new things about the environment. Have a good day, all of you. Bye-bye.